We're going to write the given 4x4 matrix in reduced row echelon form. So for review, these four conditions must be met for a matrix to be in reduced row echelon form. Number one, the first non-zero element in each row, called the leading entry, must be a 1. 2, each leading entry, or 1, is in a column to the right of the leading entry, or 1, in the previous row. 3, rows with all zero elements, if any, are below rows having a non-zero element. And finally, 4, in each column that contains a leading entry, all other elements in the column are zeros. So if the first three conditions are met, the matrix would be in row echelon form. If all four are met, it's in reduced row echelon form. And here's just one example of a 4x4 matrix in reduced row echelon form. Notice in this case, this is actually a 4x4 identity matrix. Now let's begin performing row operations to write this matrix in reduced row echelon form. Notice the greatest common factor of all the elements in row 2 is 6. So if we replace row 2 with 1/6 times row 2, we'd actually have a leading entry of 1 here. And now let's obtain a 0 in this position as well as this position. Looking at row 2 and row 3, notice how negative 2 times 3 plus 6 would be 0. So let's replace row 3 with negative 2 times row 3 plus row 2. Now looking at row 1 and row 4, notice 2 times negative 2 plus 4 would be 0. Let's replace row 4 with 2 times row 1 plus row 4. So the first row stays the same. We'll multiply row 2 by 1/6, so we'd have 1, negative 3, 0, and negative 5. And now we'll replace row 3 with negative 2 times row 3 plus row 2. So negative 2 times 3 plus 6 is 0. Negative 2 times negative 9 is 18. 18 plus negative 18 is 0. Then we have negative 2 times 1 plus 0, that's negative 2. And then we have negative 2 times negative 11, that's positive 22, plus negative 30, which is negative 8. And now we'll replace row 4 with 2 times row 1 plus row 4. So 2 times negative 2 plus 4 is 0. 2 times 6 plus negative 12 is 0. 2 times negative 1 plus 2 is 0. And 2 times 6 plus negative 12 is also 0. Notice here we have a row of zeros, which is already in the last row. Now it's obtained a 0 in this position here. Notice 2 times negative 3 plus 6 would be 0. So let's replace row 1 with 2 times row 2 plus row 1. And to make this negative 2 a positive 1, let's replace row 3 with negative 1/2 times row 3. So row 2 and row 4 will stay the same for right now. And now we'll replace row 1 with 2 times row 2 plus row 1. So 2 times positive 1 plus negative 2 is 0. 2 times negative 3 plus 6 is also 0. 2 times 0 plus negative 1 is negative 1. And 2 times negative 5 is negative 10 plus 6, which is negative 4. Now we'll multiply row 3 by negative 1/2, so we'll have 0, 0, 1, 4. So we've made some good progress. Notice how if we were to add row 1 and row 3, we would get another row of zeros. So let's replace row 3 with row 1 plus row 3. And to make this first entry a positive 1, let's replace row 1 with negative 1 times row 1. So the first row would be 0, 0, 1, 4. Second row stays the same. Fourth row is going to be row 1 plus row 3, which should be 0, 0, 0, 0. And the fourth row, we have another row of zeros. Now we almost have this in reduced row echelon form, but remember each leading 1 must be to the right of the 1 in the previous row, which means we need to interchange row 1 and row 2. So in reduced row echelon form, again, the first row would be 1, negative 3, 0, 5. Second row would be 0, 0, 1, 4. The last two rows would be 0 rows. So notice all the zero rows are at the bottom. For the non-zero rows, the first entry is 1, and all the other elements in the column with the 1 are zeros. So this 4x4 matrix is now in reduced row echelon form. But I do want to point out here, notice how this is not a 4x4 identity matrix, which does tell us something about the given matrix. Looking at our notes below, if an n-by-n matrix A is not invertible, meaning it's singular, meaning it does not have an inverse, then the given matrix in reduced row echelon form will not be equal to the identity matrix. If in reduced row echelon form it was equal to the identity matrix, then the original matrix would be invertible or non-singular, meaning it would have an inverse. I hope you found this helpful.